How to check? First of all, we check patient's visual acuity. Visual acuity may be 1 or maybe less than 1. Normal or less than normal. If visual acuity is 1, it means your patient have ametropia or maybe the so-called latent hyperametropia. Latent means no clinical signs. It's in latent form. Second step, we put the lens plus 0.5 diopters in front of the patient. If your patient has ametropia, it's clear he needs no lens. And any lens which we put in front of his eye will decrease his vision. So patient with normal refraction will say after putting the positive lens, worse. And according to these steps, you can make a conclusion that the patient has ametropia, normal refraction. First, the visual acuity is normal, and worse with positive lens plus 0.2. If your patient has visual acuity less than 1, it doesn't matter how many, 0.2 or even finger count, it doesn't matter. Less than normal. It means that your patient have myopia or hypermetropia, manifest hypermetropia, but no ametropia because his vision is poor. After that, you put in front of his eye lens plus 0.5 diopter and ask him better or worse. If your patient has hypermetropia, remember hypermetropia will correct with positive lens.
Positive lens.
He will say better. If your patient has myopia, he will say worse.
Worst.
No, I don't know. Are there any persons in your group with hypermetropia? I think not. So there are ametropic patients among you with normal refraction and myopic, even with astigmatism. So if ametropic, we've already discussed, if myopic, so first step, visual acuity, it will be less than normal, less than 1. And second step, you put positive lens, the patient will say worse. With positive lens worse, because for myopia we use minus lens. Mm-hmm. If your patient has visual acuity less than 1 and worse with positive lens, he has or she has myopia. You should correct his myopia. You take lenses from the left part of the set. Don't take only lenses from the middle portion. Only positive lens there and minus lenses, negative lens there. So you take lenses from the very beginning, from minus 0.5. And the patient with myopia will say better. You should pull the next one, next one, next one. And find the lens with which you can correct his vision till 1, when the patient can read the 10th line. After that, you should prove it. Come to the chat and check patient's vision. If his visual acuity will be really 1, you stop and make a conclusion that your patient has myopia minus, for example, minus 3, minus 2, according to the lens with which he can read the 10th line. In case of astigmatism, it will be the doctor, will be unable to correct to 1 because we use spherical lenses, but for astigmatism it's necessary to use special cylindrical lenses. It's not a task for the students. In case of astigmatism, it's a task for the student who is a doctor to correct, to find the best lens for which the visual acuity is highest. And then suppose that the patient has myopic astigmatism. The patient has myopia, maybe myopic astigmatism. It's necessary additional examination. It will be conclusion. And that's all. It's not necessary to correct the vision with its cylindrical lens. It's not for you. Clear? Clear. Okay, what about you? Do you have any problem with your
myopia?
Who has normal vision in your book?
Sit here.
We check. And I'll show you both situations. Let's start with the normal. So, you take card number 21, so refractive examination. First step, visual acuity examination, cover your left eye. Left eye. We start with the right. Cover your left eye.
Left eye.
Okay.
N. K. K. Это Т.И. Это Б. М. Ш. И.
Okay.
N.
Okay, no problem. What's the matter? The right eye is 1. What can you say about his reflection?
No.
We're not sure. Maybe it's latent hypermetropia. We can say just he has no myopia and no manifest. first time you drop them, but out of them. So we put the frame and then put the lens plus plus how many?
0.05.
And ask him. Gross. No hard metropia. It means he has ametropia. And that's all. For metropic patient, for patient with normal vision, it's the only problem.
Doctor, how is the method to diagnose astigmatism?
What are the special methods?
Touch range?
The best way is to use refractometer, special
equipment. Am I wearing
lens? Ah, you're now in the lens. Who has not perfect vision?
Okay.
Who has myopia?
Me.
Okay. So, take your cover your left eye. Do you see this light?
No.
This one?
Shit. Bit.
No.
No.
Okay, visual acuity of the right eye is 1. 0.1.
Yes.
What can we say about his refraction? He has no ametropia. It may be ametropia, or it may be myopia, or manifest hypermetropia. How do you check? By the same way, we put the... We start with the positive because we don't know.
Which time?
No, I think that we don't know. What can you say about the vision? Before and after.
Worse.
He has no hypermetropia, he has myopia. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Now, it's necessary to determine the degree of myopia. We take lenses from the very beginning. Would this lens better?
Yes,
better. But you can't, I think you can't see the 10th. Well, when you'll be ready to read the 10th line, mm-hmm. tell me this, okay?
Okay.
So, next one, minus one. Step, half a diopter. Zero, minus 0.5, then minus 1, better. But not, okay?
No.
With this lens?
Oh.
Can you read the 10th one?
Almost, but not.
Let's try?
No, not in the
bag. Not yet, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe this one is better. Than previous one?
Yes, better.
Okay, sure, it's the 10th one.
Shit, I don't see properly.
No, not yet. Okay, let's try the next one.
Oh, this one is worse.
Ah, worse. Mm-hmm. This one is better, yeah?
Yeah.
But you can't see the 10th line correctly. No. But this is the best lens. Also, we can suppose that he has astigmatism. Or maybe not only refractive errors, we don't know exactly because we didn't examine. Maybe he has any changes of variation, fundus examination, yes, and it changes in the lens. So during the operation, we can't say without additional examination. So during the operation, you will say patient has myopia, maybe myopic astigmatism because we can't correct it fully. Or maybe other problem of the eye, it's necessary additional examination. And that's all. Mm-hmm. We'll understand that you also understand the problem.
Yeah. But doctor,
how to determine it? What do I have glasses? I need to determine plus or minus. No, patient with myopia clearly say they just put them and say better or less. For all others, two ways how to determine positive or negative lens in front of in your hands. First, you should look through the lens. And we know that positive lens increase, like all the object. If we look through the lens at any object, yes, you'll see that it's really enlarge the object, yeah? Mm-hmm. Minus lens is always decrease the size of the lens. If we look through the minus lens, you see it's a smaller. Mm-hmm. Yes. The next step. The next step. We should
come on.
No difference. Look. Compare this lens, like a loop, and this lens.
It's smaller.
So positive
lens.
Negative decrease. Then, so the second object phenomena. If you look through the lens at any object, and then move your hand, for example, down or up, look at the text, and this text, for example, through the lens. What will happen if I move these glasses down? It looks like the text is always moving. Mm-hmm. You see? To the same direction. Mm-hmm. If I take this lens And do the same. It looks like the object is moving to the opposite direction.
Yeah.
I move my hand down, but the object is moving
upwards.
Up. Up.
Yeah.
In case of minus lens, the object is moving to the same direction. In plus lens, it looks like it
opposite.
To the opposite direction. Also very easy phenomenon. If it will be a simple glass, I mean without any direction, there will